Hi guys, good morning, welcome to Ozzy's group. And today I am back again and with one more nice topic. And today's topic is not just relevant to people who are studying IELTS, but it's a very basic grammar topic. So first of all, wishing you a very, very happy Saturday and a very, very good morning. For those of you who are joining me live today or seeing me live today, thank you so much for being there with me this morning. It means a lot to me. If you're watching me, please press the like button. It shows that, you know, you're there with me, and throughout the presentation, you're going to be there with me. Let me explain you the drill of it. So first, what we are going to do is I'll explain the concept to you. We'll go through a presentation. At the end, you can ask me various questions that you feel about it. Obviously, it's a live session, so if you have questions in the ongoing lecture, please post it in the comment box. And also, if you're watching this on YouTube or if you're watching this later on Facebook, please make sure that if you have any doubts, you can post it on Telegram, you can post it on IELTSTutorials.online, or you can post it on the comment box and I'll be very happy to help you. So for those who have your exams, this is a quick tip, a quick revision, because through which you could lose your marks, and hence we're doing this. And for those of you who are preparing writing, please make sure you follow these rules. And for those who have exams and exam jitters, any last minute queries would be welcomed. Post it in the comment box. It's good for people who are going to appear, who are going to prepare. And for last minute tips, there is a webinar that I've taken last Saturday that's very nice. So please go through it one more time. Okay. So let's begin the concept without much ado. So if you realize, we've taken band descriptors of the speaking component and the writing component. Over a time, what we realized is that there is one, you know, component that holds 25%, that it has 25% of the weightage in band descriptors, and that is the GRA. Now, time and again, I have been explaining you that grammatical range and grammatical accuracy are two different concepts, right? So grammatical range implies the use of simple, compound, complex, whereas grammatical accuracy implies like a combination of a lot of subjects, starting from articles, punctuation, subject-verb agreement, noun-pronoun agreement, tenses. Right. So a lot of students, when I read their papers, even the ones who are very proficient in English, they tend to be really well with the sentence formation, the basic structures and everything. But there comes one topic in which a lot of students make a lot of mistakes, and that one topic is called subject-verb agreement. Now see, the concept of subject-verb agreement is very, very basic, okay? It just means that a single subject should have a single verb, whereas a plural subject should have a plural verb. Now, when I'm talking about this, what I realize is that when it comes to implying the rules, I mean, you know, you applying the rules for yourself, that's when it becomes very, very difficult, right? So now, when I am talking about this, let's make sure that we do not have any glitches related to this. Hence, I have identified 10 rules of subject-verb agreement, which we are going to learn today. Each and every rule will be explained to you. And if any rule you have a doubt, just post the comment box which rule you have a doubt, which rule number you have a doubt, and I'll be answering that for you. So without much ado, let's begin our presentation. And any doubts, any queries, feel free to ask me. So yeah, coming to the basic concept of subject-verb agreement, okay? So the basic concept of subject-verb agreement says that a single subject gets a single verb, whereas a plural subject gets a plural verb, right? So it's a very easy concept, it's a very simple concept. So see, let's see the first example that is given here. Okay, the first example says, the dog is playing with the ball. Okay, now when I say dog is playing, dog is a singular subject here, right? Dog is a singular subject here. Hence, my verb is going to be is. Why? Because verb is becomes a singular one. Now, when I'm talking about dogs are, okay, so dogs is a plural subject. Hence, the verb concept is going to be are. If right? Okay, moving on. So I hope this concept is clear to you. A single subject takes a single verb, a plural subject takes a plural verb. So the dog is playing, the man is walking, Ram talks, Ram and Shyam talk, people are moving, a person is moving, the population is increasing. Okay, now there is one thing. When it comes to the base verbs, I'm talking about we out here. Okay, so now when it is singular, does not have an S. But the verb, when it is singular, has an S. Like I'll explain. A person. Okay, person is singular. Chair is singular. Chairs with an S is plural. But chair, person talks. So talks is singular. People talk without an S is plural. So it's the opposite for the noun and verb. Remember the rule of opposite. A singular verb will have an S. A singular noun will not have an S. A plural noun will have an S. A plural verb will not have an S. I hope this again is sorted with you guys. Right, let's move on to rule number one now. The rule number one says that two or more nouns joined by an and. Now see, when I'm talking about and, okay, I am talking to something, some, you know, and is always used for plus. If you've studied probability, you would realize it, that and is always and always used for plus. So because and is used for plus, the verb that I'm going to use with it is plural. Okay, because and is used with plus, the verb that's going to that I'm going to use is going to be plural. But if and denotes the same person, same thing, for example, the poet and the critic was criticized, was opposed, because here I am saying the poet and the critic is one person. Time and tide wait for none. So wait, because wait is again your singular one. Okay, horse and carriage is at the door. So horse and carriage is obviously, the carriage cannot be without a horse. So bread and butter is my favorite, because butter cannot be without bread. You know, I'm referring to one breakfast dish out here. Okay, so let's understand this rule one more time. And the first rule is the rule for and. When I am referring to the rule for and, what I mean is, and always denotes two things, okay? So whenever there is a thing of plus, whenever we're adding on two things, it's always going to be plural. So I can say, the mobile and the laptop are in the bag, okay? Because I'm talking about two different things. One is a laptop, one is a mobile, okay? Ram and Shyam are going for a walk. So I'm talking about two people out here, Ram and Shyam, right? So that's why it's plural. But when I use and to refer one single thing, for example, I'm talking about the same poet, I'm talking about the same person who is a poet and a critic. So at that point of time, the poet and the critic was condemned. So I'm talking about one person right now. So hence, this is going to be and, okay? Are you trying to understand what I'm trying to tell you? Time and tide wait for none, because you're again referring to one thing. Bread and butter is my favorite, so I'm again referring to one thing. Remember this, okay? Let's move on to the rule number two. Now see, when I'm using and, okay, I'm referring to two things, okay? Hence, it's going to be plural. But when the words are joined by a singular subject, that is with, as well as, they should always be in particular, because here my subject is just one. Getting it? So here my subject is just one, hence I am going to use a singular verb. So for example, president with other ministers was there at the conference. Why? Because here my main subject is president. You're getting it? Here my main subject is going to be president, hence it's going to be was. The house with its contents was insured. So though contents is plural, okay, house is going to be singular. Getting it? So please be very, very careful. Right. So I'll give you more examples of this. See, when I use words with as well as along with, together with, I am talking about the main subject. So for example, the book along with its introduction was very catchy. What was my main subject? The book. Introduction is already included in the book. So that's why was. The team with its players has arrived. Okay, so team and players are not two different things. I'm talking about the team. Team is a singular, is a collective noun. So I'm giving it a singular verb. So hence, it's going to be has. Okay, let me give you one more example. The man with all his cars keeps on showing off. So my subject is the man, not the cars. Getting in? So please be very careful. So we've learned two rules so far. When two different things are concerned, the first rule is and. Whenever there is and, you have to plus it. So I'm talking about two or more things. Whenever I'm talking about two or more things, it's always going to be a plural verb. When I'm talking about and but referring to one single thing like bread and butter, it's going to be a singular verb, right? Okay, the same thing is going to be the opposite when it comes to words like as well as together with, along with. I have to identify the main subject. The main subject has to be given a verb. So the main subject is singular. The verb is going to be singular. So if singular plural is confusing you, please go through the samples. Okay, let's move on to the next rule. Rule number 3. Okay, two or more singular subjects. When two subjects are singular and are connected with or nor, they always require a singular verb. Now, why is this so? When I used and, I used two verbs. But when I used or nor, I'm using one. Because when I am referring to the word or, it simply means that I'm going to pick one out of the two. Okay? So, that's why you have to be very, very careful. Getting it? Okay, so see the first example. No nook or corner of the jungle was left unexplored. So no nook or corner, I'm talking about one thing. Either the cat or the dog. So I'm talking about the dog. Okay, now see this. Again, when I'm talking about and, okay, I'm talking about, you know, joining two or more things. When I'm talking about or, I'm choosing one out of the two. Okay. So, because I'm choosing one of the two, so either the girl or her mother is coming. Okay? See this. Either the girl or her mother. So, either the girl is coming or her mother is coming. Either of the two are going to come. So, I'm going to use is. Okay. However, the concept is opposite when it comes to and. So, the girl and her mother are coming because when I'm using and, I'm implying that both of the people are going to come. Right, so when both the people are going to come, what am I going to say? Are. But when I'm using the word either, that means either one of them is going to come. So one becomes a singular one. So I hope this rule is clear to you. Remember, and is going to be plural, or if two verbs are singular, it's going to be singular. Because or implies one subject. Okay, now see, when this was the rule when it comes to the singular subject. When it comes to the plural subject, what I am talking about here is the verb which is nearer to the subject. See this, neither the team captain nor the coach is to be blamed. So it's going to be is out here. Why is it going to be is out here? Because coach is singular. Right, I'm going to choose the word, I'm going to choose a subject which is closer to the verb. Okay, neither the CEO nor the board members. So now see, board members is plural. Okay, so I'm going to pick the word are. So I'll give you more examples of this. See this, neither the girl nor her friends are coming. Okay, our biggest friends is plural. Okay, neither her friends nor the girl is coming. You see the opposite. I'm going to repeat it again for you. Okay, so neither the girl or her friends are coming. So friends are are coming, okay? Neither her friends nor the girl is coming. So friend is the girl is coming, okay? Keep this in mind, guys. Okay, let me give you one more example. Okay. Either sweets or some fruit is good for me. Okay? So fruit is singular, so I'm going to use is. Either some fruit or some sweets are good for me, because sweets is plural, so it's going to be are. I already have a sweet tooth in the morning, so yeah. Okay, that's all I could think of. Okay, let's go ahead, let's repeat what we've done so far. Okay, the first, and so far, if any rule you really have problems with, please post in the comment box. I will be answering, explaining that rule again. If you feel I'm going too fast, please post that as well. I'll be going through that again with you. So let's go ahead right from the top. And plus. So, Ram and Shyam are walking. But when I use am to refer to one thing, like for example, the poet and the critic is waiting. So I'm referring to poet and critic when they're one person. Of course, when they're two different people, I can't use this. Okay? Clear. When I'm using or with two singular subjects, it's going to be always one, because when I'm choosing or, I'm going to ask, you know, select one. Either tea or coffee is fine for me, because I'm referring to tea or coffee. Okay? One thing. So, is. Okay. Now, same thing. When there are plural subjects involved, what is going to count is the subject which is closer to the verb. So what I'm going to take is, for example, the chairs and the table is dirty. The chairs with an S and the table is dirty, because table is nearer to the subject. However, the table and the chairs are dirty. Okay, the table or the chairs are dirty, because chairs is plural. So three rules so far, I hope all of them are clear to you. Okay, let's go for rule number five now. Now see, whenever either, neither, each, everyone, many, some, they always have to have a singular verb. Now see this, I'll explain. Okay, see this. Boys are talking. This statement makes sense. Yes, everybody. Everybody's with me on this, right? So, boys are talking. Boys is plural. I'm taking the subject are. Each of the boys is talking. Okay, I repeat this. The boys are talking. Okay. Each of the boys is talking, because when I'm saying the word each, I am referring to people who are singular. I'm talking to boy as one entity again. Okay, everyone. Every one of you is wrong. So when I'm talking about everyone, I'm talking about one. Everybody is waiting. So though I'm referring to a large group of people, I'm going to be is. Somebody is waiting. Somebody has stolen this. So I'm talking for everybody, every, each, nobody, some, it's all going to be is. Please be very careful with this rule. Okay, let's move on to the next rule. Right. Every boy and girl was given a cycle. Now see, why every, each and every takes a singular verb. As I explained the rule before, whenever you're using every, make sure you use and. Okay. So by far we've learned three rules regarding and. Let's repeat. When I'm using and, just to add on two things as a simple statement, like Ram and Shyam, I'm going to give it a plural verb because I'm talking about two things. When I'm using and to denote one thing, I'm going to give it singular. Like for example, bread, butter, bread and butter is my favorite. Okay. Now, when I'm using each and every, that time also and gets a singular thing. Each of the boys and girls was lying, because each is there. When I use the word each, I am referring to each person, one individual. That's going to take a singular verb. Okay, let's refer these three rules related to AND very, very carefully. When I am using AND to join two things without any other things, for example, both population and poverty are increasing. Okay, both population and poverty are increasing because I'm talking about population and poverty club together, so it's going to be R. Okay, when I'm using AND to denote one single thing, when I'm referring to one thing or one person, the teacher and the singer won award. So when I'm talking about the teacher and the singer, I'm referring to one person. That person is one. The person is not two different things but has one two occupations. So in such a case, what's going to happen is that I have to give that person the singular format because I'm talking about one person. Again, the same rule. When I have joined the words with each, so each of the boys and girls was lying. Okay? Each of the tables and chairs are dirty. Every single, every table and chairs are dirty. Okay, whenever each and every is there, please use the singular format. So we've done three rules by five. Okay, let's go to rule number 7. Now see, there are some rules which are plural in form but singular in meaning. Like news, moms. So just because, okay, now see, remember this thing. Just because it has an S in it, okay, just because it has an S in it, doesn't really mean that it is singular or doesn't really mean it's plural, okay. So please make sure that there are words like, you know, physics, there are words like mathematics which are not really, you know, plural. So please be very, very careful with them, okay. So make sure that this is something that you realize. For example, physics is the most fundamental, least significant of the science. Okay? The news is about Sushma Swaraj is true. So Sushma Swaraj is also singular, news is also singular. So please be very, very, very careful with this. Okay, let's move on to the next rule. Okay, now see, this is very important. Whenever you have a collective noun, okay? The collective noun always takes a singular thing. But however, when it is thought as a whole, so for example, when I am talking, the team has arrived. So when I am saying the team, like what are collective nouns basically? So see, nouns are of different categories, proper, common, abstract, collective, common, countable, uncountable. So when I am talking about a collective noun, okay, so collective noun is always referred to as one entity. That's why it's given the designation of a collective noun. For example, a bunch of students, you know, a fleet of ships, herd of cattle, a chest of drawers, team of players, committee. So when I'm talking about such things as a single entity, for example, the keys are stolen. That makes sense because keys is plural. So definitely the word that I'm going to use is keys are stolen. But when I'm saying it differs like radically when I say the bunch of keys is stolen. Why? Because when I'm talking about bunch, I'm referring to it as a single thing. I'm referring to it as a single entity. Okay. Now see, the stars are beautiful. Okay, so stars is plural out here. Ships are sailing. So ships is plural. But when I'm saying a fleet of ships is sailing. So fleet is again collective. Getting it? People are waiting outside. So when I'm saying people are waiting outside, that means that a lot of people, so people is plural, so I've given it R. However, when I say a group of people is waiting outside, that means I'm referring to one group. So it's going to be is. See the difference. People are waiting outside. A group of people is waiting outside. That's the difference. Okay. The team is playing well. I'm talking about a team as a singular entity. The players are playing well. Again, I'm talking about players as a plural entity. Getting it? Okay. Now see, here's the difference. When I talk about this thing, but some words like committee, audience, jury, crowd, okay, orchestra. So what happens is that it takes the plural verb when the individuals of which is it composed of a thought. For example, the committee are divided in minor points. I'm talking about committee as separate individuals. Committee has issued its report. See, here I'm talking about committee as a group. Okay, when I say the committee has issued its report, that means here I am talking about the committee as a group. But when I say the committee are divided on one minor point, that means when I'm talking about the committee, I'm talking about separate individuals in it. On a simpler note, you can always give a collective noun a singular verb. That is the easiest form of it. You know, when it comes to grammar, it's my personal opinion. The more you complicate it, the more it becomes complicated. In fact, learn simple rules and learn how to apply them in your, you know, day-to-day writing or day-to-day speaking. It's much more easier. Right. Now see, when there's a proper noun, okay, but it's a plural and it's a collective unit, it has to have a singular verb. So Arabian Nights is still a great favorite. Arabian Nights is a name of a book and it's one book. So that's why it's going to be is. United States has a big navy. So again, you know the rule that I told you earlier, that if I am talking about it as a singular verb, okay, if I'm talking about it as, it's just because it has an S doesn't really mean that, you know, it is singular. Plutarch Lives is an interesting book. So this is, I'm talking about one book. Gulliver's Travels was written by Swift. Okay, now see this. Lot of people, you know, think that, okay, S is plural and then they'll just give it, give them a plural verb. Avoid it. Understand that though it, like, for example, news. You know, news has an S. Physics, mathematics, it has an S. Maths, exactly what I told you. Just because it has an S doesn't really mean it is, you know, plural. It can be a singular verb. The same is the condition out here, right? So when you're talking about a verb, about a subject, please identify whether it's properly singular or properly plural. So when I was talking about United States, I'm talking about one country, right? Please be very careful with it. When I'm talking about Gulliver's Travels, I'm talking about one book, okay? When I'm talking about Three Lives, I'm talking about one, you know, book again. So please be very careful with what it is, what the subject is. You know, the key to actually solve your subject word agreement properly is identifying the main subject. If you've identified the main subject properly, there's absolutely no way that you're not going to get this correct, okay? The last rule. this is like a proper exemption. Now see, when I am using minutes, kilometers, or you know some specific quantity, most of the times it's going to be in singular. However, it might depend. So for example, 15 minutes is allowed to each speaker. 10 kilometers is a long walk. $30, 50,000 rupees is a large sum of money. Like, I can say 50,000 rupees were spent on charity. Okay? There were 30 minutes with the countdown. Thousands of dollars are spent each year on child education. Okay, so I hope these rules were very clear to you. Guys, I hope you've watched this. And if you're watching this, please like this. Let's do a quick summary. The first rule that we really, going through by the important rules out here. The first rule that we learn is that if you're using and, you plus two things. Because you plus two things, you're talking about two or more things, that's going to be in plural. For example, Maharashtra and Gujarat are states of India. So I'm talking about two states, it's going to be are. Okay, when I'm talking about one thing, when I'm referring about one thing, I'm going to use is. For example, tea and coffee is my favorite. Again, when the third rule pertaining to and is, when I'm using each. For example, each of the countries and the continents was sad. So I'm talking about each. So because my word each is there, I'm going to use the singular word. Okay. The next we learnt about or. There are two rules when it comes to or. Firstly, whenever there are two singular subjects, it always takes the singular verb. Because when I'm talking about two singular subjects and I'm talking about or, that simply means that I'm going to pick either one of it. So tea or coffee is my favorite. Okay? Fruit or vegetable will do. Right? So I'm talking about one thing. But when the same comes to plural, when there is a plural subject involved, what really happens is you have to consider the subject that is closer to the verb. For example, the boy and his friends are coming. His friends and the boy is coming. Okay, so be very careful with this. The third rule that we learned, another rule that we learned is usage of each, every, somebody, everyone, each and every. So this always take a singular one. For example, the boys are lying. Okay, each of the boys is lying. Okay, people are talking. Each person is talking. Okay, so please be very careful with this. Coming to collective nouns, majority of the times collective noun is given a single entity. Because we've spoken about collective noun, let me tell you, even abstract nouns are given a single entity. Uncountable nouns are given single entity. For example, courage. Courage is rare. Happiness is rare to find. Happiness is something which is eternal. Okay. So please be very careful with it. Even the uncountable nouns. For example, air is polluted. The music is loud. Okay. So be careful with it. Okay. Moving on, another rule that we learned was, again, there are words that end with S, they might not be plural. Common noun, both common and proper. So mathematics, physics, measles, they're not, you know, plural, they're singular. Same thing when it comes to, you know, the common nouns, like we read few examples in United States. So I've explained all the rules pertaining to subject verb agreement. Guys, when it comes to grammatical range and accuracy, again, I am repeating, it holds 25% of your weightage. It holds 25% of your, you know, marks. So please be very careful with this. If you're watching this with me, if you're with me, please put a like button and please put, you know, subscribe to IELTSTutorials.online. You can join me on Telegram. I would be happy to help you. Any doubts in this particular lecture, I would be, you know, very, you can just put it in the comment box. I would definitely review it and I would definitely answer you. If there are certain statements or certain examples that you're confused, more than welcome to put it so that others can learn. And to those who have your exams, please don't have exam jitters. Please don't feel nervous. Be very, very confident. Okay. And hence, hoping for the best. All the best, guys. I hope you guys do really well. Again, there is a separate webinar on grammatical range which has been taken. That's about simple, compound, complex. You can do, please do go through it. Another thing that's really nice is the webinar that I took last week. It was about last minute jitters and everything. So make sure you're doing it right. Make sure you're actually studying it properly. And if you have any doubts and preparations, you can log on to IELTSTutorials.online. If you want to read writing samples, we have an application for writing that's called IELTS Tutorials Writing. You can please go, you know, through it for a time. And no problem. I will see you next week. All the very, very best, guys. And it was great to have you here. And thank you so much for all the support. It really motivates me. And wishing you all a very, 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 very happy weekend and lots of good scores. And this is Vidisha again. In case you have any, you know, doubts, you can address it in Telegram. We'll be happy to help.